And now to our interview segment. My guest, Wole Olanipekun, SAN, is arguably one of the country's leading lawyers. Between 1991 and 1993, he was the Attorney General and Commissioner for Justice of the then Ondo State. He also served as the President of the Nigerian Bar Association in 2002. He's a former member of the National Judicial Council, NJC, and a life bencher. In this interview, we talk about tackling corruption in the country and the judiciary, and also about the outcome of the elections of the National Assembly.
I want to get your thoughts on the National Assembly elections and the way things have turned out. What do you make of all of it?
My take is this. Nigeria does not, as of now, have viable political parties. PDP was there. PDP has been defeated. But which party defeated the PDP? APC. APC was a sort of amalgamation coming together to drive off the PDP. From what happened, you will now see that the far corner and the far corner, they don't hear themselves. They don't gel. They don't flow. They don't see eye to eye. So you see different factions within even the APC itself. I want to believe that the APC has to put its house in order in the interest of the nation. For us to have political stability in this nation, the party in power at any given time must be disciplined. PDP was not that disciplined, and they lost the election. But then, they lost the election at what cost? Nigeria was virtually rudderless. Because what were they doing? Who was governing? Who was in charge? Now, are we starting on that note again? I want to caution that APC, as a party in power, must reorganize itself, must look backwards, must look at how, where its shoes leak and the shoes pinch, and where the roof is leaking. Because we can see that, as of now, things, you know, have fallen apart. And it's too early, too early. One does not expect that. You can't discipline me if you cannot discipline yourself. And then you are not even entitled to govern me if you cannot govern yourself or govern yourselves, as the case may be, members there. And you know, I also see a lot of alignments, some, you know, alignments. PDP solid. Block vote for the president of the Senate. APC, maybe about 10 of them. But are we witnessing? What are we witnessing? We must be careful. There must not be a reincarnation, a reinvention of what happened during the Nigerian Governors Forum. We must prevent that. We can't afford it. But having said all this, the Senate must move on. I want to plead with the remaining members, with the 54 members, let them go back to the Senate. Let them support the Senate President. Let them support the Deputy Senate President. Because as a lawyer, there is no way you can annul it. The president made a proclamation. They sat. I will not call it a treachery, but I think that they outsmarted themselves. One faction outsmarting the other. I think that was what happened. But then, intrigues here and there. But the intrigues must not be carried too far.
Let's talk about justice sector reforms. What are the reforms that you think that Nigeria needs the most? And what would you commend to this administration, especially when you look at the anti-graft war and, you know, the stance of this administration that they would give priority to that? We have corruption in the judiciary too. So what would you commend to this administration, especially in terms of judicial reforms?
I don't think we need specialized courts. We have courts, more than enough courts, that can take care of them, that can take care of every aspect of our national life. Is it corruption? Is it commercial? Is it banking? Is it land matters? Are you talking of chieftaincy? Are you talking of dispute between, you know, two citizens or citizens intersea? I believe we have enough courts. What we should do, again, discipline. Again, leaders must try now. Their motto, their mantra should be, do as I do, not do as I say. And when I talk of leadership, I mean the political leadership, the executive leadership, and the judicial leadership. Talking about corruption in the judiciary, we have to look at it from different angles. What type of judiciary do we have in Nigeria? We say we are Federal Republic of Nigeria. Our judiciary is unitarized. Our judiciary, like every aspect of our national life, is on federal. You have federal courts, we must have the Supreme Court. Supreme Court has always been there. Right from the time Nigeria was even still imagined, Supreme Court has always been there. We have the Court of Appeal, federal. You have the Federal High Court, federal. You have the National Industrial Court, federal. To my mind, two powers are vested, too much powers are vested in the Federal High Court. Jurisdiction, everything under the sun, federal courts. And I can see what I would describe as arrogance of jurisdictional arrogance. State high courts are left with nothing, virtually nothing. What I would call agrarian jurisdiction. Maybe landlord and tenant, maybe somebody is owing you 10,000 naira, 1 million naira, so total. These are the things that state high courts now, apart from Lagos, and maybe Rivers, and maybe a state like Kano.
Where they have vibrant judiciaries.
I won't talk of that they have vibrant judiciaries. They have some things to deal with.
Okay, the economic life there is more buoyant.
Yeah, more buoyant than what we have in other states, So you leave the judiciary in the states almost prostrate. They do nothing. Now, if you have problem in Lagos State sacks a staff of the Water Corporation, you have to go to the National Industrial Court for redress. To me, I think that is not right enough. Now, the judiciary in Nigeria must be restructured, must be reorganized. When you look at Section 57 of the 1963 Constitution, otherwise labeled as the Republican Constitution, state religions had the right to establish their own appeal courts. Western state or Western region had its own appeal court. Let me elaborate. I don't think it is right for any judge outside a particular area. Let's take the Southwest, for example, Yorubas. You have Yoruba customary law on inheritance, on marriage, on traditions, on land, on whatever. I see no reason why the Southwest or group of states that want, any group that wants a court of appeal cannot come together and have their own court of appeal. So that whatever litigation ensues in respect of marriage, in respect of land matters, in respect of chieftaincy, in respect of things that are peculiar to that particular area, will end one, go from the high court of that state, of that group, of that region, of that zone, then from the high court to the court of appeal, from the court of appeal to the Supreme Court of that zone. That is the way to solve the problems of this nation. You don't expect me to go now, if I'm a judge, to go to the north, or to go to the east, or to go to the south-south, and except I'm pretending, to some extent, to be adjudicating on their customary law, on marriage, on traditions, on land matters, things that I don't know much about.
But why not? You can learn it.
You learn it, but by the time it will be trial and error in some cases. But then, for people who are from that area,
they are more familiar,
yes, and they are more thorough, and they are more learned, and they are more capable, and they are more able. They are within familiar terrain. It's not something that we have to listen, study briefs of counsel, then you make pronouncements. It's so natural, faster. Then you relieve the Supreme Court of Nigeria, you relieve the Court of Appeal set up by the federal government of some duties, you know. So they have less to grapple with, and administration of justice will move faster. Then you talk of corruption in the judiciary. I don't belong to the school of thought that when you want to deal with corruption in the judiciary, you just come, you sack judges. No. We did it. We experimented it. During the time of Muritala Obasanjo, the best of our judges, one of the very best of our judges, they were sacked on television, on radio, without doing that, without giving them, you know, the right to fair hearing, and we suffered for it. A good example, woke up one morning, we heard that the late Dr. Teslim Olawale Elias, one of the very best the Commonwealth produced as at then, and even as at now. He was Chief Justice of Nigeria. He was relieved of his appointment. Up to now, we have not been told what he did. Thereafter, he went to the World Cup, World Court. Somebody we rejected here. Everybody must be given the right to fair hearing. I think the way to go about judiciary, the corruption in the judiciary, is to allow the National Judicial Council to do a thorough job. Give it support, the wherewithal, and allow the National Judicial Council free hand. Now, the NJC is doing a lot of things. They are introducing a lot of innovation. One of them is that for you to get to the bench now, you have to go through a lot of procedures.
Yes, the interview, advertisement,
yes. Then people, members of the public will have the opportunity to comment. If I've been practicing with a colleague at the bar for quite some time, and I know, I would actually know him very well, except that I too don't know what I'm doing. And in that process, I see his name, I wake up tomorrow, I see his name, he wants to become a judge. If he's good, I would write, he's very good. He's a capable man, he's a capable material, he's a fit and proper person, and he will be a round peg in a round hole. But if I know that he does, it's not, if I know that he's fraudulent, if I know that he's you know, very untidy or very tardy, if I know that he's someone who doesn't, you know, 2 + 2, he will say it's 3. Or at times, when he wants to do a guesswork, he say 2 + 2 is 5. Then I will have to write that, please, I have my reservation. I might not say more than that. And members of the public also, they, no, they will. Members of the public will have the right to say, if you have given a lawyer a brief, and through negligence, through inadvertence, through carelessness, through incorrigibility, through greed, through fraud, he's messed up your case, and that kind of lawyer wants to go to the bench, or even the magistrate, then you have a right to petition. You know, in the USA, judges are elected. In Britain, you can't become a judge of the High Court until you have taken the seat, until you have become a senior, a Queen's Counsel,
which is our
equivalent of senior advocate of Nigeria. So by the time we restructure, by the time we start from the base, by the time we start from the base of the pyramid, the mode of appointment, it's not something we can resolve today. We are planning for the future.
This is where we wrap up this edition of the program. But by all means, do let's keep the conversation going online. You can send me a mail, a Facebook comment, or a tweet on any of the issues on the program today. Don't forget that you can find this and past episodes of the program on our YouTube channel. I'm Shola Shieli. Thank you for watching.